If you want to draw a block diagram or a flowchart or any kind of drawings, the best package you can use is called tikZ. You can also pronounce it tikZ. But in order to use the tikZ package, you have to write a lengthy code and put a lot of options. In many applications, you just need to convey a simple idea using a block diagram like this in your presentation or thesis or in a book. So in this video, you will learn how you can do this sometimes even with a single line of code. So let's get started. So the package which we are going to use instead of a tikZ package is called smartdiagram, and the package smartdiagram is built on top of tikZ. So it loads a few libraries on auto when you use smartdiagram's package, and it uses all these libraries. We want to use LaTeX, but we don't want to put too much code. So therefore, in this situation, Smart Diagrams is a wonderful package. So this package provides us a few types of diagrams. Like this is called a circular diagram. So when you create this diagram, you just put it like a list. So within the curly brackets, you put these four elements. So it will draw the circular diagram because the package knows what is a circular diagram. In the beginning, this will automatically assign colors to these elements, but you can change those colors. Similarly, this is a circular diagram again, but this time we are using circular elements. Each of the element is also a circle. So this package also allows you to change the shape of the element. Ellipse is another shape you can use. The second type of diagram the package offers us is called flow diagram. Another type of diagram this package offers is a descriptive diagram, in which you have two portions. On the left hand side, you can put any title, and on the right hand side, you can put a description. So this is also very helpful to convey some ideas if you want to put in a presentation. Then there is a sequence diagram, which has two flavors. You can have sequences in different colors, or you can have a uniform color of all the sequences. So we will see how we can make this diagram. And this is a little bit modification of the flow diagram. So we can modify this flow diagram using some additional elements by using another library, which is called addition. So let's see how we can code all these examples. So here is a LaTeX program. If you install LaTeX on your computer, you can type these four lines of code. And this is a standard minimum code. Actually, three lines are minimum for any LaTeX program. And then this package we are using here, which is called Smart Diagram. And therefore, these are the four lines. If you have installed LaTeX, you can quickly type these and you can start doing what I am typing here, and you can quickly see the result as well. So if you are new to LaTeX and you don't know anything about LaTeX and you are watching this video, then there is another video which I have made where I show how to install LaTeX. LaTeX has three components: LaTeX distribution, then this editor in which I am typing right now, and then the PDF viewer, Acrobat, which you are all familiar. So the only thing you need is the LaTeX distribution you have to install. And all of these things are free. So I will put a link to a video in this video. So you can watch those videos, how to install LaTeX, and then you can just open your editor and type these four lines and you will be with us. So now let us see how we can draw this circular diagram. The first one, the default one. So what you have to type here, / smart diagram. And inside the square bracket, you will type circular diagram. And then you will put the elements, whatever you want the elements. For example, if you look here, these are four elements. So whatever text you want in these elements, you will put in a list fashion. Very simple. So I will just put text 1, text 2, text 3, and text 4. Very simple. And now if I compile this, it is not centered, but it will draw the diagram with simple one line of code. Here is our diagram. So how cool it is. As you can see that it is very simple, just one line of code, and you can quickly draw this diagram in your LaTeX document. The best way is to center this diagram. So for that, what we can do is can use a center environment. Begin center and center. So now the diagram will be centered. If you look at this diagram, this is counterclockwise. Now let us see how we can make this diagram clockwise. So to make this clockwise, you simply have to put a word clockwise here with after a colon, clockwise, and now if you compile the diagram would be clockwise diagram. Now it is centered and it is clockwise. And now what we want to do is we want to do a little bit of customizations. So I will just copy this, paste it here. For customization, we have to use a command called smartdiagramset. And then you start the curly brackets, and within these curly brackets, you put your options. For example, I want to change the circular distance. So I would say circular distance equals whatever distance I want to have, 4 cm. If I want to change the font, I would say font equals / large, as you use fonts in LaTeX. If you want to change the text width, you would say text width equals 2.5 cm. If you want to change all those elements are called modules. So modules minimum width, you can specify module minimum width. You can put a little more than text, for example, let's say 3.5 cm. Then you can have module minimum height, let's say 1.5 cm. And then you can have option for arrow tip equals 2. This is the simplest option. So if you want to see more options of these arrow tips, so you can have a look at section 16.4 of this PGF manual. This is a document of PGF package. You can find this on C10 website. And if you want even more options, then you read this section 16.5. In this, there is a library called arrows.meta. If you use this library like this, use PGF library like this, then you can have even more options. You can see here, there are a lot of options here. So you can have many arrow types. So all these are available in section 16.5. So now these are the options which we have changed, and another change I want to do is put another fifth element or module. So now if I compile this, so there is an error. We don't want font / here. Recompile. And now we have a circular diagram in which we have 5 modules. And now you can see that we have 5 elements. Circular distance has increased, and the fifth color has been automatically assigned to the number 5 module. And now what I want to show you is that you can use a library called Smart Diagram Library Edition. So by using that library, you will be able to annotate your diagrams. So how can we do that? In the preamble, before the begin document, you put this statement: use Smart Diagram Library, and within the curly brackets you put additions. Just double check the spellings and everything is fine. So now we can add some annotations which I have already shown to you. Let's have a look again. These are called annotations, which are external additions. You can also call it additions. We will do these annotations later, but first we want to change the shape of this rectangle. Instead of rectangle, we want circle and diamonds or ellipse, these type of shapes. So how to use that option? So if you want to change the shapes, then you have to use another library, which is tikZ library, and which is called shapes.geometric. What we put here is use tikZ library, and then within the curly brackets you put shapes.geometric, and now you can have more shapes in your diagrams. So let us copy the last one and paste it here, and now we can have one more option, and I have to copy this option as well. So just copy these options, paste it here, and the extra option we get here is called module shape equals, let's start with diamond, comma, and then rest of the options are same. So I just want to change the shape of the module. So if I compile now, and now this we have the diamond shape. So you can also have a circle and ellipse shapes, which I am not going to do. So let us see how we can make this flow diagram very quickly. So we can just copy this again, paste it here, and instead of circular diagram, now we say flow diagram. Now flow diagram can be horizontal or vertical. Like circular diagram can be clockwise and anti-clockwise. So we have to tell the program what type of flow diagram we want. So let us say we want horizontal, and instead of test 1, test 2, we want step 1 and so on. And now our flow diagram is ready. But there is one more thing you should understand here, that this option command, smart diagram set command, is affecting not only this one but all the subsequent diagrams. So therefore we have to make these options comment so that you can see how a default flow diagram will look like. So this is no default because there are no option commands here, so everything is in the default mode. So I first compile this. And now all these diagrams are in default mode, and this is our default flow diagram. And now you can of course customize it, and there are many options available. So what I do now is, because this video is becoming too long, so what I will do is I will put a block of code here, and then I will explain, because now you know how these diagrams are working. So I will just copy from one of my files and I paste this code here, close this. And now I explain everything in here. So this is our flow diagram. So the next diagram is the sequence diagram. So first let me compile this whole code, and then I will explain what this all means. So now everything is in the default mode, as you can see here, and this is our default sequence diagram, and this is our customized sequence diagram. So there must be a set command in between these two, and then this is the description diagram, and finally we will modify a flow diagram using additions library. So these are called additions and annotations. So let me explain how this all works. So the first command is here is the sequence diagram. So you just change the name of the diagram type in this first square brackets, and then the rest is same, whatever text you want inside the sequence command, you can put it here. And this command is the option command, which is changing the option of this sequence and making it black and white, or gray and white you can say. Text is white but other thing is gray and white. So what are these options? So what are these options? The first option is uniform sequence color true. So it means that we want a sequence diagram which has uniform colors of all modules. Then we have an option sequence item border color. So this is the border color of this. Border color is black, and then the text color is white. So border color is black. Now the font size is footnote size. So footnote size is a LaTeX command which sets font size a little bit smaller than the normal. So as you can see that this font is smaller than the normal font. Then sequence item text color is white, and what this is doing is setting the text color of these sequence modules or the sequence items. And now then we put this sequence diagram command, and all these options are applicable to this command. So this is what is happening here. This is the default, and then after options this changes to this one. Now this is the description diagram, and as you can see that all these modules have only one piece of text inside. So this module has step 1, step 2, and the modules of a sequence diagram have also only one part of the text, one part text. But this description diagram, one module is this whole thing. It has two parts. So how we tackle this in the descriptive diagram? So this is the descriptive diagram, and if you look here, the difference is that this is the curly brackets of descriptive diagram, and each of this bracket has three subset brackets. So this is first subset, which has the contents of the first element, the title and the description. And this is the second element. So basically what is different in the descriptive diagram is that you have to put an extra bracket
insight for every element, because every element has two components. And now what are these options? These options are for the additions. So within these two curly brackets, all these options apply to the additions and these options apply to the diagram. So this is the difference you should note. Uniform color list gray, this applies to this gray. So these are the main module items and these are additions. So all the items within this bracket which is highlighted, all these items which has these additions or additional item, all these are applicable to only this part, this border color, this arrow color, the arrow shape, and all these options. So all these options are within a separate bracket, and within the main bracket we have option for the flow diagram. So this is a modified flow diagram, which is a vertical flow diagram. So now let's look at the options. So we are saying the uniform color list, this is the color type. And if you don't know why we are writing color like this, then there is a video about colors, which I will put a link here in this video. So you can watch that video. That is the title of the video is Colors in LaTeX or something like that. And for three items means we have three items of the main flow diagram. So additional item offset 1 centimeter. This is the distance between these two. So this is the addition item offset from this 1 centimeter. Then additional item border color is green. As you can see, this is border color is green. Then the arrow color is red. Arrow tip is stealth, which I have already shown you. Section 16.4 of the manual, PGF manual. Then additional arrow line width is 1 point. You can increase the width of the line of the arrow, thick arrow I mean. You can increase this to 2 point, the arrow will be thicker. And then additional connections disabled is equal to false. What does this mean? If you don't put that, then these additional things will not be connected to this diagram. In some situations, you might want this to be separate. You just want to put this beside this, but no arrow. So if you want something like that, then you will just make this option true and it will not be connected. But here we want connected, so therefore we are putting this false. And then instead of smart diagram, the second thing is that when we previously we were putting this smart diagram command, but now we are putting a different command which is called smart diagram add. It means this will plot the smart diagram as well as all the additions, all the additional things. So now this command will plot this and also this thing. So this is a separate command for this type of situation, so which is called smart diagram add. And the last bit of this code is this part. And what this part is doing is it has two pair of curly braces. So the first part is just the elements of your diagram, which are the text in these three modules. You have to put this text with the separated with commas. Now the last part is, if you look here, there are few positions left of module 1. So it means that you want to put your addition left of module 1. So module 1 is the keyword. So you cannot put this M capital, for example. This is a keyword. So left of module 1, then you put this slash and whatever text you want to put in your additional block. In our case, we want this low level. So this is left of this module 1. So there is nothing on the left of module 2. And then we have left of module 3, some other text. And this is what is happening here. There is comma and then left of module 3. We have a text, some text. So this is how you use this add smart diagram add command. It has two pair of curly braces. On the first, you put the elements or modules of the main diagram. And in the second pair of curly brackets, you put the positions left or right of whatever module you have. So in a nutshell, in this video, what you learned is you learned few commands: smart diagram add, smart diagram set, and smart diagram. So these are the three commands you learned. Then you learned how to use these two libraries by using these two commands and how to use this smart diagram package. And if you watch this video carefully and you read the manual of this package, then you should be able to make all types of flowcharts and block diagrams very easily. So we have already compiled this and we have seen that this is the output of this file. So that is it for this video. Thanks for watching.